Greetings and welcome to episode number 8. In this episode, we'll go through and talk a bit about how we are going to be creating a light map for a model. So before we create the actual light map, I want to explain to you what it is and why it's important. A light map is used to store data of how lights and shadows should behave for a model. In order for the model to store that data correctly, we have to create a light map, which is an unwrapped UVW in a separate channel. This means that we will have one unwrapped UVW for our texture and a second one for our light map. You're probably thinking right now, so do I really have to create a light map in order for my lights and shadows to behave correctly? And the answer to that is yes and no. See, the light map is mostly used for optimization purposes. If I know that my box is going to be a static model or a static mesh, which means that it won't be moving in the game at all, then it's a great idea to create a light map. With the box not moving at all, the game engine can then calculate what part of the box that should be more lit up than the rest of it. When it's done calculating, it saves that information into our light map. When we then run the game, we already have the light information saved in an image, and my computer can quickly locate it and apply it to the level. If we don't really want to use the light map, we can use dynamic lights instead. This is more taxing and heavy on our system. What that does is to send information between the box that we have and the light, constantly updating the light even though the box isn't moving, which means that our graphics card is spending time on something that we really don't want it to do. Now, one dynamic light and one box isn't going to do that much to a graphics card. However, let's say that we have a room filled with 1,000 dynamic lights and 1,000 boxes. Having them constantly updating will indeed reduce the performance of a graphics card. So you should always get in the habit of always creating a light map for your model. It sounds like a lot of extra work for my lights and shadows to show correctly, but it will be worth it in the end. It is also worth noting that when you're working on projects like ArcViz or realistic renderings, you have to use a light map. You won't get the same result with only dynamic lights. A combination of both dynamic lights and static lights are great. Alright, to create a light map, you have to do a second unwrap UVW. Now this time it gets a bit more complex since the model has to be unwrapped in a different way. If we don't unwrap the model or do a poor job of unwrapping the model, it may or may not look as good. A badly unwrapped model will give you random and weird looking shadows in places where you don't want them. Okay, so a normal unwrap UVW like the one we did before can be done in all possible ways. But when it comes down to the light map, you have to keep certain things in mind. Those things are: create a second UV channel for the light map. You need to have one channel for the texture and another one for the light map, unless you can use the first channel as your light map and texture, which rarely happens. Do not overlap any faces. Each face or geometry needs to have its own space. To not get light map bleeding, which means that the edges or the UV scene will show light and shadows incorrectly, we need to keep space between all the faces of the geometry. Don't stitch together all of the geometry. A good rule of thumb is to not stitch together any edges that are between 90 and 45 degrees in angle. But this will depend on what type of light effect you're going for. If you end up with a bad result, it's only your fault. Not the software, not the game engine. You just did a poor job and should try again. Lastly, there are a lot of techniques and you will develop your own way of creating a light map in the future. Don't be shy and look around for other videos that will cover the light map creation process. Okay, I hope that you understood some of the information that we talked about just before. So let's begin and create our own light map. The first thing that I will be doing is to remove one of the boxes from the scene. We only need one box. What I will be doing now is to rename the box to something more fitting and then center it back into the scene. I will then go into the modifier list and apply the unwrap UVW modifier to my box. From this point on, I will go into the command panel and change the map channel from 1 to 2. This will now open up a dialog box asking you if you want to keep your existing UVs or if you want to abandon them and create completely new ones. Whatever you choose won't affect the rest of the video since we're going to apply a flatten mapping to the entire model. You should now select all the faces and go to mapping and then select flatten mapping. You can just press OK in here. You now want to go down to Arrange Elements and change the padding 0,02 to 0,07. Then you want to press the icon next to it. This will now give the faces more space between each other. Also, by doing this, you will reduce the chance of the box getting any light map bleeding as we talked about before. You can now go ahead and close down the UV editor and then collapse the modifier down to your model. As soon as you have done that, you are essentially done with the entire model. So, congratulations! In the upcoming episodes, I'm going to be showing you how to export and import the model to Unreal Engine 4. So stay tuned for that. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. And I will see you in the next episode.